total and complete shutdown of Muslims entering the United States.
If we don't ban further immigration from Islamic countries, our way of life will be lost.
I think that what is important for people in Australia, learn from the U.S. If you take your eye off the ball for even a second, you could end up with the orange man. And in this case, the orange lady.
I can see in Donald Trump a lot of me, what I stand for in Australia.
Now is the time to get together to make it clear that we learned something from America. We're not gonna be on the back end. We're gonna fight on the front end. Resist like you've never resisted before. My name is Tamika Mallory. I am one of the co-chairs of the Women's March on Washington.
Thousands of Americans at this hour are descending on Washington, D.C.
Thousands of women are marching today in cities across the country. Rallies
over 600 of these marches in all.
We applied for a permit for 200,000 people. But as we got closer to January 21st, we knew that 200,000 had been blown out the water. I was like watching it from my peripheral thinking, oh snap, this is going to be huge.
The Women's March on Washington had already become the largest inauguration protest in history.
Yes, we can! Yes, we can!
750,000 people marched in LA, in New York, all over the world. We just literally shifted American culture in one day. I'm sure that Donald Trump absolutely saw the Women's March, and he not only saw that we were there, he knew we were more powerful and had more people than he did on his inauguration day.
Love, not hate, makes America great.
I believe that all protests make change, because even if you just change one person's mind or win one person over to your movement, it is important work. At the end of the day, sometimes there has to be actual boots on the ground to give a visual of people's challenge of any particular issue.
America cannot be great without me, you, and all of us who are here today.
So when I was a little girl, my parents used to drag me around town to all the rallies and all the political engagement stuff, all the activism. We were there.
Remember not the words of our enemies.
They wanted me to really continue the tradition of being a social justice fighter. And I was like, what the hell is that? Why is this being, you know, forced upon me? But, you know, I had a very tragic incident to take place in my life. And once that happened, I began to understand the importance of the movement.
But we will not stop until they go somewhere and sit the hell down.
When my son was 2 years old, his father was shot and killed. He was involved in some type of illegal activity, and those people who he thought were his friends, they ended up killing him. What if they didn't have a gun? Would he have at least lived through the experience? I don't think that we can ignore the fact that there is a problem with access to guns in this country that not enough people are working to fix and to change.
We're gonna wanna know from the NRA, what are they doing about the fact that we don't have sensible gun laws in this country?
Whenever you are a person who chooses to speak against the system, it's a dangerous spot, because you're opening yourself up to the hate that exists among people who can't understand you, don't want to understand you, or are just literally racist and hateful.
I'm talking to you, Tamika Mallory. You write a letter to the NRA on behalf of the Women's March claiming our Clenched Fist of Truth ad was an attack on minority communities.
It is very clear that the NRA's ad, it was targeting me. And certainly since then, the amount of, you know, death threats and calls, the hate has increased.
That feeling, take it back with you to wherever it is that you came from today.
Every single generation has a responsibility to make it better for the generation that's coming. I am fighting some of the same causes that my parents fought for, and that's just, like, sad. They brought me into the movement, and here we are with young people who are younger than me, and they are fighting still some of the same issues that my parents and I have fought.
Donald Trump, go away!
You don't stop just because it seems like the politician is more powerful. Organize and work with people. And if you make that connection, you begin to bring people from different worlds together, and no one can defeat you.